Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over 10 tips to hopefully make you a little more efficient with using your Outlook calendar. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So first of all, start up Microsoft Outlook by going down here on the toolbar and typing Outlook. You can click the icon here to launch the Outlook app. Once you're in Outlook, go down here to the calendar and just click on that. And this is where we will begin our tips for today. So the first set of tips that I have for you, help with the issue of not knowing when someone else is free when scheduling a meeting. So there's a couple different ways to do this. So tip number one is how to share a calendar. This is my calendar right here that I'm using inside Outlook. And if I would like other people to be able to see my calendar, I could right click on here and go to sharing permissions, and I can click add, and I can add any of my contacts in here to be able to share my calendar. So I'm going to click on my friend, click add, and then click OK. And not only can they view my calendar, they could also edit my calendar if you would like them to be able to put events on my calendar. So in this case, I'm just going to say can view, and I'm going to click OK. And now that person can have access to my personal calendar. Tip number two is an add-in inside Microsoft Outlook. First of all, I'm going to go back to my email here, and then I'm going to click this button up here. And I can search my add-ins, and this time I'm going to put FindTime and select it from the search results. And I'm going to click the button that says add. And remember this icon up here, because that's what we are going to be looking for. So if I go back to my calendar, and if I go to new appointment and give it a title and go down here, I can do my new meeting poll and find a time that works for everyone involved in the meeting. Tip number three also involves meetings. If I go up here to new Teams meeting, not only can I set up a meeting with someone else, but I can set up all of the links for Microsoft Teams. So I'm going to click this button, and I'm going to type in Teams meeting, and I can invite people here out of my address books. So I'm just going to invite my friend, and you can see right here, here's the link to the Teams meeting. And so when I send this to my friends, they're automatically going to have the link to our Teams meeting. So not only have I been able to set up who comes to my meeting and what time it is, but I can also automatically have a link for where we are meeting online. Tip number four is really fun, but we have to use the online version of Microsoft Outlook to do this. So I'm going to go to outlook.com, and I'm already logged in here. But if you go here and you're not logged in, log in first and then click here on your calendar and then click add calendar. And here you have so many options. Click this link right here for sports teams. And you can also click a link here for TV shows and the TV show schedule. Or you can click holidays, and you can add all the major holidays for your country to your calendar as well. Tip number five is back in Outlook. If I click on my calendar and then I go up here to view and I click on these three dots, I can go to color and I can pick a color for this calendar's events. So right now light blue is selected and I would like to leave that. But if I select the United States holiday calendar and if I go over to color, I can change that to say yellow. And then if I select my calendar and the holiday calendar together, I will see that one of my calendars is in blue and the other one is in yellow. So I can use colors to quickly let me see which calendar I am looking at. And then if I right click over here and I go to overlay, I can see both of my calendars in the same calendar. So it's kind of a merged calendar of all different events. So if you have a personal calendar, you could add that here as well, and you could give it a different color, and you would know just by looking which calendar it came from because of the color. So this is really helpful in having a quick view of everything you have going on. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. Number six is actually an email tip that has to do with your calendar. So if I click on email and I go to new email and I go into the body of my email and I go up to insert and go over to these three dots, I can actually insert my calendar, and I can do it from a date range. I can do just today's calendar, or I could do the next 7 days. And if I click OK, I can send this to anyone and they can have an idea of all the events that I have scheduled in the next coming week. So they will know not specifically what my events are, but if you look here, they will know that I'm busy during this time and I'm free during these other times. So this is another way to let other people see what your availability is. Number seven is a good tip for people who feel like they're in back-to-back meetings all day and you have no buffer time in between your meetings. Usually, if I go up to new appointment, you can see that I have a half an hour appointment scheduled right here, it automatically does my meetings in half an hour increments. However, if I go to File, Options, and I click on Calendar, you can see that my default durations for new appointments and meetings is set to 30 minutes. But if I shorten them, I have an option here to end early or start late. Usually you want to end your previous meeting a little bit early. And then if it's less than an hour, it's going to shorten my meetings by 5 minutes. But if it's an hour or longer, it's going to shorten my meetings by 10 minutes. So in this case right here with a 5 minute shortening, I will really have a 25 minute meeting by default. And here, if I say 1 hour or longer, I will really have a 50 minute meeting by default. So I'm going to click OK and go back and go to a new appointment. And you can see right here that now my meeting times are being set from 8 until 8:25. So I am getting that 25 minute meeting, which gives me a little bit of downtime in between back-to-back meetings. Tip number 8 allows me to view a quick to-do list of what I need to do once I'm inside Microsoft Outlook. So if I go back to my inbox here and I go to View, Layout, and go down to the to-do bar, if I turn on Calendar, I can see my calendar on the side right here, and I can see which meetings I have automatically. And if I change the date, I can see the different events are changing based on the date I've picked in my calendar. So even though I'm in my email view right now, I can actually see my to-do list of all of my upcoming meetings without having to go back down here, back to the calendar button. So that's really helpful when I'm working in email all day and I just want to see what's coming up next. If I go back to calendar, I can right click on my calendar and go to add calendar. And here I can add someone else's calendar. I can add a calendar from the internet. I can add a shared calendar that someone has sent me. I can also add a room list of all of the rooms that are available for my meeting. So when you're working in an office building, not only do you have to schedule people to show up at your meeting, but you also have to schedule a place to meet. So this is a very helpful tip to know, to be able to see the calendar of what rooms are available. And this last tip is perhaps one of my favorite tips. If I go back to my inbox and I've had an email come in and I want to schedule a task to do this email at a future date, if I click on these three dots here, I can just select meeting, and this automatically sets up a calendar event for the email that has come in. So I'm just going to leave this one as is, and I'm going to schedule it for today at 11:30, and I'm going to hit send. And if I go to my calendar, I can see that that event that I just had from that email has automatically created a calendar item for me. And if I double click that calendar item, the entire body of the email has been automatically put into this meeting request. So I use this for when I want to take an email that's important but not urgent, and I want to schedule it as an event on my calendar so that I will get it done in the future. And I don't really have to think too much about the email because the email itself is automatically turned into a calendar event. So I can have all of those details of the email show up on my event in the future. So hopefully these 10 tips will help you become a little more efficient with using the calendar in Microsoft Outlook. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. I hope you learned something new, and I look forward to seeing you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.